In this video, we're going to talk about and prove the Dominated Convergence Theorem. This is one of the most important convergence theorems ever. And so far, the other two convergence theorems we saw were the monotonic convergence and the Fatou lemma. Those two were useful in the cases where we have non-negative functions. But now, the Dominated Convergence is useful for any real-valued or even complex-valued functions. If you haven't, I recommend you see at least a video on Fatou's lemma, because it's actually going to be used to prove the Dominated Convergence. Before we start, let me remind you that if you find in these videos helpful, then you can consider donating on Ko-fi with the link in the description of the video. Every small donation helps us bring more videos like this one. Let's see what the theorem is telling us. It says that we have a sequence of functions in L1. Remember, we saw this in our last video, L1 is a bit more complicated than this, but basically is the family of functions that have finite integral. It's again more difficult than this, but I explained it in more detail on our previous video. So we have this sequence that converges to another function f almost everywhere, and this is pointwise convergence. So for almost every x, fn of x converges to f of x. And also, there exists this function g in L1 that dominates our sequence. So g is greater than the absolute value or modulus of our functions fn. What the theorem says is, under all these hypotheses, the limit function f is in L1, and we can take the limit outside of the integral. The integral of the limit is equal to the limit of the integral. And this might seem like a lot. I'm asking for pointwise conversions and also for the existence of this function g that satisfies this. Yes, those are two important hypotheses, but we will see that often this happens, so it's not a problem. I'm going to assume that my functions are real valued, because if they were complex, then pretty much the same would work by dividing it into the real and imaginary part. So I'm just going to focus on functions f that go from my set to the real numbers, where x is just the measure space, x with the sigma algebra m and the measure mu. Let's look at the proof. The first thing we have to prove is that f is a function in L1. For that, this hypothesis is going to be useful. Our sequence is dominated by a function in L1. So f of n is less than or equal to g for every n. And this happens almost every. So because this happens for every n, then it will happen for the supremum. And then f is also dominated by g. So now we have to prove that f is in L1. For that, we have to calculate this integral. But because f is dominated by g, then this integral is less than or equal to the integral of g. And g is in L1, so this is finite. Great, then we have the first part, our function is in L1. Now we have to prove the second part. We are now able to write this because the function is in L1, and we have to prove that we can pull the limit outside of the integral. For this, let's first pay attention to this. We have that minus g is less than or equal to f, and f is less than or equal to g. This just follows from this inequality. So I can subtract f on each side, and this would give me minus g minus f less than or equal to 0 less than or equal to g minus f. From this first inequality, I can multiply by minus 1, and that will reverse this inequality, and it will give me that g plus f is greater than or equal to 0. And from this other inequality, I have that g minus f is greater than or equal to 0. So now I have two non-negative functions. then we can use, for example, Fatou's lemma. And the reason why I'm using Fatou's lemma is because I know nothing about this sequence fn. If I knew that this sequence was monotonic, then maybe I could use the monotone convergence theorem. But I don't know that. So Fatou's lemma comes to the rescue. Fatou's lemma, however, gives us an inequality. But if you've seen the video on one of the exercises we solved, we said that to get equalities from inequalities given by Fatou's lemma, what we're going to do was force to get a negative sign on fn that will then give us the superior limit. So this is what we're doing here. We are forcing having this negative sign because then from here we will recover the superior limit instead of the inferior limit and then have the equality we want. Let's start with this one. We will integrate g plus the integral of f. This obviously is just the integral of g plus f. And now g plus f is a non-negative function, so I can use Fatou's lemma and this will give me the inferior limit of g plus fn. Well, the integral of g doesn't depend on n, so this is just equal to integral of g plus the limit of the integral of fn. Okay, so we have this. Now let's see what the second one gives us. So if now instead I integrate g and subtract the integral of f, this is going to be the integral of g minus f, and now this is again a non-negative function, so I can use Fatou, which will give me the limit of g minus fn. Again, g doesn't depend on n, so this is just the integral of g. But now the limit of minus the integral of fn is minus the lim sub. So let's see what we have. In this first one, I can just cancel g and g, the integrals, and get that the integral of f here is less than or equal to the limit of the integrals of fn. And in the second one, I cancel g and g, and then I have this minus less than minus. So I multiply by minus, and this less than becomes a greater than. So in this case, I have that the integral of f is greater than the lim sub. So now, using both these two things, we have that the lim sub of the integrals of fn, these are smaller than or equal to the integral of f, and this, the purple one, gave us smaller than the limit. And now, since the other inequality is always valid, we have an equality. We have that the lim sub is going to be equal to the limit, then the limit exists and it has to be equal to this integral. So then the integral of f is equal to the limit of the integrals of fn. And that finishes the proof of the dominated convergence.